Lord, who can stand? What with you is forgiveness, that you may be revered.
I hope in the Lord, I trust in his word.
I trust in the Lord. My soul trusts in his word. My soul waits for the Lord, more than the sentinels wait for the law.
I hope in the Lord, I trust in his word.
More than the sentinels wait for the law, let Israel wait for the Lord. For with the Lord is kindness, and with him is plenteous redemption.
I hope in the Lord, I trust in his word.
And he will redeem Israel from all their iniquities.
I hope in the Lord, I trust in his word.
He silenced on Mary's presidential burden. As the silence of being. As he called dignity and honesty to service the nation as our president, he preserved the dignity after his retirement. It was the silence of noble statesmen, now mayor and forgotten. It was the silence of the Amatui. It was the silence of the baby. That sense of dignity that we truly miss now. He endured the terrible cross of his self-confidence with courageous dignity, with uncomplaining fortitude, even from the night time, knowing only God. It was like the quiet humility of the Lord Jesus before Pilate. Then for him came like a thief in the night, as the gospels say. Namatay siya sa kanyang pagkakamali. But then, it was not also surprising. Pinoy died as he did. He served without fanfare. He abhorred our trappings and our cheating. His victory quietly, as much as possible, disturbing the one. Well, now come, very annoying, and not surprising. Ngayon man, kung nagulat tayo sa kanyang pitang pagkano, magmasig tayo sana sa mabulansa. Hindi na dapat na tayo magulat sa kanyang sa eulogies have been written and spoken and shared. But the best eulogy tribute can pay our dear President Tony is to bring back, recover, preserve, safeguard, and never again compromise our dignity as a people and the decency of our leaders as servants. The flags of Amnas are not only for the dead president, but for the dying decent governments. Tayo Bosnia, Pilipinas, we are grateful for you. The greatest among you will be your servant, says the Lord. From our human memory, 61 is an age too young to die. But his relatively short life is a fitting reminder for us that what matters indeed is not how long we live, but how. After all, Christ died for the freedom of you. When you are given a chance to serve, serve. A chance to lead, lead. A chance to soar high and make the people soar high. He responded to the call and gave us his best. Your light will shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your love. He did it. He made himself an easy target of his content, trolls and bashers. But focused vision is the rule of his leadership, the rule of his leadership being. And what a brave and strong visionary was. Visionary was. He still had so much to teach us about decency and integrity. He still had so much to teach us about good governance and professionalism. He still has so much to teach us about self-sacrifice. going has joined the pantheon of the great and has entered into eternity. Peace where sickness can no longer threaten, where faith loses no more place, and foes are dead. Where God's commandments are no longer transgressed, and God's name is no longer blasphemed. Where vulgarity and brutality and terror is vanquished by compassion. Where God is love alone made supreme. That is where we lead in this gospel world into the new heavens and the new earth. We who are left behind, sighing, mourning, and weeping in this land of tears, must still toil under the heat of the sun. We still have to enjoy the oppression and violence and vulgarity and friendship. For the testimony,
Please rise.
Thank you.
giving thanks to you and God is worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that we're taking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world that you the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Modesto, our Bishop, our presiding Bishop, Socrates, and Pablo, and all those who minister to the Gospel in all the world.
Remember your servant, Benny Rosignol, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son at the death of thy face may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them in the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, first apostle, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may never be equal heirs to eternal life, and may praise.
kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with yours.
ministry. Grant it may be my God that your servant makes him known, who today has shared for his brother. It may be sacrificed in thanks and free from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We will now pray the big prayer for the big one and the next one for one of the other.
Lord, help us to see death for what it really is, the end of poverty in the beginning of riches, the end of frustration in the beginning of fulfillment, the end of fear in the beginning of tranquility, the end of pain in the beginning of joy, the end of weakness in the beginning of strength. Let not grief overwhelm us or a sense of loss embitter us, but out of our sadness let there arise a new joy, for so much has been given to us. Cast out our fears and let not our hearts be troubled. Let your spirit of peace come alive within our experience and hurt, our sorrow and isolation, our sadness today, and loneliness tomorrow. We humbly commend to you, Benoit, whom you have called out of this mortal life. You love him always with great love. Now that you have freed him from all the evils of this earth, bring him into your paradise, where there is no more grief, or mourning, or sadness, but peace and joy with your Son and the Holy Spirit forever. We thank you for all the blessings you have given to the glorious mortal life. We pray that we may be able to glorify you with the life of healing and the way he has used his blessings. Lord God, grant that we will never forget that life is short and uncertain. Let your Spirit guide us in holiness, justice, and service to our brothers and sisters. We pray for the healing of all unhappy feelings from his death and our needs in our hearts. Be with us, Lord, during our moments of sorrow and loneliness. You are our rock, our fortress, and our strength. We trust in you and hope in your glorious resurrection. We lift up to you our grief and sorrow, confident that you will change our mourning to rejoicing, that our beloved glory now rests in your peace. Eternal rest grant unto the Lord, O Lord.
And perpetually
shine upon. May he rest in peace.
Amen.
May the soul of the Lord, the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
Please be seated. We listen to the message from the family of the late Benigno Senior Romeo Cuno.
She had told us that her dad was taken so suddenly from the fire.
the rain will not be for the believers in you, Lord, to be buried in the tomb of your passion. Let us pray with confidence in God who gives us life all for us, that you raise up this mortal for names to the perfection and comfort of the saints. May God give him merciful judgment and forgive all his sins. May Christ, the good shepherd, lead him safely home to give peace to God our Father. May he be happy forever with all the saints in the presence of our eternal King. Let us say together, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Saints of God, come to his aid, come to meet him, angels of the Lord.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
May Christ who called you take it to himself, may angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
May thy eternal shine upon him, O Lord, may your saints forever, for you are merciful.
Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Where Lazarus is poor no longer, may you have fair prayers. And may you have gathered with your neighbors in the blessings of the Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let's go,
thanks be to God.
Thank you.